Hi folks, just a quick intro to a latest project. Been having ignition trouble with the Series 3. It's got the 5 bearing 2.25 petrol engine, late model truck, 109 1983, if you want all the numbers. But it's always run quite sweetly, as they should, but just of late developed a really lumpy tick over and a bit of a misfire. Say you come off dual carriageway, come to a roundabout for example, drop a gear and go to pull away and it just splutters and it hasn't got any power, and it seems to be ignition trouble. Put your foot down hard and away she goes. But looking at the distributor, there's a lot of wear in the spindle and I think that's causing the problem. Until you put your foot down and the vacuum advance kicks in, and away you go again. Could be wrong, but there we are. What I've done, because I can't afford one of those nice rebuilt Lucas jobs, I had to buy a cheap Chinese copy from a well-known parts supplier. And the main casting's okay, they've got that right. Although I had to re-tap some of the threads to make it a little better. But it's been bored okay. I've actually checked that all the way through and it mics up pretty true. This, however, it had a somewhat freshly ploughed look to it. So, as it happens, they leave the machine part slightly proud of this bit where the drive dog goes, so I've just trued it all up, made it a more regular shape. At least though, there was no discernible play between this part here and this part here. Got the advance mechanism, might just be able to show you. I checked that with the DTI and it's well within tolerance, so I'm happy with that. But things like the rotor arm, very poor, and the distributor cap. You can see where the rotor arm's been going around and striking all the contacts, way too hard. And I would say that that brush is too hard as well. What I've actually done, I've got a genuine set of points, because these, that's too hard and brittle, and the spring's too hard. There's too much play between that and the pin there, and the points don't even line up. Whereas these, as you can see, much better, and the springs have the correct tension as well. Proper distributor cap and rotor. Unfortunately, couldn't get hold of a genuine rotor, but this is a pretty good one, much better than the other one. Anyway, the thing that really lets it down is the bearings, and it should have a full-length bronze bearing all the way through there. But instead it's got two of these little sintered steel jobs, one at the top, one at the bottom. And the top here was about 3 thou thinner than, say, there. So there was a lot of play between that and the spindle. So it was no good from the off. So I've got a lump of bronze here, and I'm just going to turn some bearings. And I've bought a special reamer for it as well. It wasn't cheap, but again, it's one to add to the toolbox, so it's worth having. So we'll get cracking, and hopefully we'll have a sweet running engine again. So I'm just assessing the new parts and whether they'll fit. And surprise, surprise, the genuine cap doesn't want to fit, you see. So what I've got to do, just pop this casting in the lathe and just skim a little bit off the edge there, just make it a good fit. Well, I thought it was going to be a job for the four-jaw chuck, but amazingly got away with that. It's only aluminium, so unsupported, we got away with that. But just taking 3 thou off it, it's a beautiful fit. Difference such a small amount of metal makes. Right, well, the last test before we go any further is just to put the rotor arm in and the distributor cap on. You remember I had to remachine the casting for that to fit, but it is now perfect fit. Now you'll have to excuse me holding it in the vise like this, but as you can hear, the rotor isn't colliding with anything. So I've obviously got the bearing on the centre. I was a little bit worried about having distorted the aluminium through having heated it. Didn't heat it very much, but I was just a bit concerned about it. But it seems fine. So there you go. Just check the contacts, but no, it looks fine. So in the next video, I'll get it put together and hopefully get it fitted up. Well, here we are, we have the finished project. All that remains now is to fit it and see if it actually works. But it all looks very promising. I've checked the points gap at each hump on the cam, for want of a better term, and it's the same. There's no play in the spindle, so that part should be really good. Only thing I have any concern about is the advance mechanism here, vacuum advance. I expect that's too strong, so it may be that I have to put the advance unit from the old distributor on it. But we'll stick it on there, see what it goes like. And fingers crossed, it'll all be good. That's the new distributor fitted. I'll put the engine to top dead before I remove the old one, so I know it's on top dead on cylinder number one, which is pickups just there. Right, distributor's fitted. Let's see what happens. Not bad, it's pretty cold this morning and we had a bit of snow earlier, so yeah, I'll go with that. Well, it's looking promising because it's sitting there ticking over with no choke. That is right in, by the way. And normally I would have to wait till it was a lot nearer the normal mark, if not bang on, before it would run like that. Still have no power, I expect. I mean, normally you'd do that and it would just misfire and splutter. That's better. So we might be able to drop the idle speed now. My focus, which is running quite well. I only managed a couple of miles on the test drive. Two problems. First of all, the speedo cable was playing up, so I came back to sort that out. Went out again, and believe it or not, the throttle return spring snapped. Should just be in there. Been to the local motor factories, like Ironmongers, everywhere around here, and I cannot find one. So, I've had to bodge it with a little stretchy spring rather than a twist type, like it should be. So I'll have to go online and see if I can find one. But at least it seems to be running alright. It's driving a lot better for the few miles that I did do. Much more power, get off choke sooner, and the smoother tick over. Just to show you all that's wrong with the old distributor. First of all, lots of float side to side as well, and at the top of the shaft, that's particularly bad. There's lots of movement in the moving plate there. It's worked by the advance mechanism. If you see that, that's quite bad. But the biggest problem by far, certainly won't have been helping, is that point set. Now, I bought this vehicle, I knew next to nothing about Land Rovers, and there are quite a few different point sets, I believe. I think it's two or three different ones. You can have two types of Lucas and a, I think it's Distillia distributor. I've obviously fitted the earlier Lucas type, and how I missed that there was no receptacle for the little brass pin underneath it, I don't know. So the points have been sat there at an angle. I've done about 6,000 miles with this, trouble free until now. So, kind of, whilst it's embarrassing for me having made the mistake, it does show what a robust little engine the 2¼ lump is. It's quite something, actually. So, yes, quite bad. Anyway, what I'll probably do with this one is take it apart, do exactly the same, put a new bronze bush in there, and see if we can do something with it, keep it as a spare.